Associates.
Hello.
I don't even know what that is.
Well, there's two of them, so let's look at each one.
They're all into the same car.
Like I said, I mean, it's like, if you get out, this is the money store.
Yeah.
If you get outside of bankruptcy, you know, these are bought debts, so I mean, sometimes you can settle them for a lot.
Okay, just look up.
And then this one, the next portfolio.
And the next part of our house, we're talking to kitchen, which is like.
My Best Buy. Okay.
Okay.
And then the ECAS is the one you asked me about.
So let's get a furnace.
And that's about $3,500 and.
Furnace. And all.
Best Buy was $3,211.
No, the ECAS.
Oh, ECAS.
Citibank.
Yeah, Citibank.
Let's get
a credit card.
Yeah.
I can figure that out.
Get a pound cake.
Yes, anyway. You can tell by the amount.
Yeah.
Then you had, your ledger, your house.
That one should be off of it because.
It is.
Well, yeah, they invented it. Down here, so I got one. I got changed. So we got two more portfolio recoveries. One's $485.91.
That was Walmart.
And then the other one is $12,000.
U.S. Bank.
Okay. So yeah, it looks, doesn't look like they're. Homeowners Association ever filed anything.
Yeah.
So they, you know, so they won't get paid. We just talked about Citibank, Walmart, GE Capital, yes, US Bank, Chase. These are the ones we listed. We have a Bank of America card for $1,097.81. Did they file a claim?
I'm sure they did. It says amount still owed $1,097.81.
No, that's what Michelle. Okay, hold on. That's what happened.
I'm sure they did.
No. What she's showing you, that's what she put in from what. Those are the things we listed in your schedule. So let's turn when we go through this list. You got a pen there you can grab?
Yeah. Can I use yours?
Absolutely.
All right. And your green paper too?
Oh, yeah. So just see, because one of the benefits, in other words, you may pay more money than negotiating, but one, you don't have to worry about tax obligation, and two, all right, so the U.S. Bank one, the U.S. Bank is listed on that list there, right?
Yeah, that was for $12,036.
And the Honda is there?
I don't see the Honda on here.
Okay.
That would be under what finance company? Honda Financial?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not on here because I think they got all their money.
Okay. Then we talked about Connecticut, so mark down the Connecticut one.
Mm-hmm.
That's $4,000.
Are you marking these off so we know which ones I have?
Marking them off?
That was what we were doing here.
Oh, okay. Let's start all over. I got you.
Okay, so we start off with U.S. Bank.
U.S. Bank.
And then you're saying Honda Finance is not on that list.
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure what happened there, but it got fixed. Connecticut is there.
Yeah.
And then we talked about Quantum Group 3.
Yeah, it's on here.
Okay, that's Comedy Bank, so.
Yeah.
And then Portfolio Recovery, the first one again was.
Best Buy?
Yeah, we had Best Buy, we had GE Money Store.
Room Store, you mean?
Room Store, I'm sorry.
Okay. Yeah, Room Store, and then Walmart.
And then, for Citibank.
Yeah.
And then we had $45.91 with portfolio.
Yeah, that's Walmart.
Okay, and then we had the $12,000 for portfolio, which is
U.S. Bank.
Okay. So is there anyone not on the list?
Bank of America, $1,097.81.
So So if you pay the Chapter 13 trustee, then that debt will be discharged because it, and you won't pay them anything because they didn't file a claim.
So that's the amount right there that I pay? And that,
no, you don't pay them anything. They didn't.
No, he means if we want to discharge it and pay everybody off rather than have to worry about taxes, that's the amount at the very bottom.
They won't
minus
that.
No, the Bank of America.
Right, minus
right.
The Bank of America.
Because they didn't file a claim. So if they don't file a claim, then they don't
paid.
Get money when you pay it off. So that's why he was having you mark off the ones that he has a claim for. Because any of them that they don't have a claim for, then if you were to pay it off...
Why would they not put a claim?
Because they maybe they missed the deadline. Maybe they...
Sometimes they
don't care. Yeah.
They make a decision that $1,000
is not worth it to them.
The
so
employees, 2 hours of putting together the claim.
Okay, so.
So when we're ready to make the payment, we talk to Michelle. Michelle
she will call
give
them
us,
up.
Yeah.
They will give her a sum certain.
Right.
You'll submit that as you normally would to the trustee or by certified funds to Guy and Kearns at whatever payment address is. And then. Then you will we will receive a notice of completion of plan. We'll have you sign a piece of paper that acknowledges you're eligible for your Chapter 13 discharge. And then you will see a piece of paper that is your discharge. It says you owe no more money to any of the people listed on your
so
creditor
if
list,
come after you.
Except for the,
right.
Obviously you still have to pay on the house and you still have to pay on your homeowners association.
Yeah.
But I just want to be totally clear.
Once you have that paperwork, if anybody comes and says, hey, you owe us this money from 2014.
Yeah, because they'll sell these things. They'll keep selling them. So if somebody says, you owe us, for the U.S. bank debt, you go, no, I discharged that in bankruptcy, and here it is. Literally, when you get your discharge.
Oh, so they would still sell it to another collector?
Yeah, because they're assholes. Yeah. Oh, sorry.
She's heard worse.
Yeah.
How dare them?
Yeah, and then Bank of America could try and say, well, we didn't know about it or something like that. It's like,
you were on the claim?
You're on the claim here, right there. We sent it to you at a valid address.
Yeah.
Bank of America probably has an address that they tell the bankruptcy court to use. So they got no excuse.
There you go.
Okay, so that discharge just, it's like a brick wall against creditors.
Right. So the benefits of the, paying the trustee are paying a sum certain. You don't have to worry about, and that's it. She'll give you a number and you're done. Okay. Dismissing the benefits are you may not have to pay so much.
But the drawback is that you have to worry about the tax.
Well, there may be tax consequences. And the amount of money, the 40. The 40% on the, the 40 cents on the dollar you're settling for is not that number because we're 2 years past that number.
Yeah.
So, most of these credit cards are 20-25%, so you owe half, so that's 50% interest in 2 years, so you owe half again on top.
Oh, so once you dismiss, discharge, they tack that interest back on.
Right, and then you would be settling 40% of whatever the number is they now view it as being. No, never mind.
So it would be a discharge, and when that time comes, once we get the money, then we'll be moving right away on that.
Yeah, her 3% is nothing compared with their 50%.
So is that the figure with the 3% included?
No.
No. The number is...
What would her 3% be? A 40...
It would be 3% of whatever you pay.
Figure that out real quick.
It's not worth figuring out because
it's not. It's minimal.
We have to find out from
your
rate
of
pay.
Gotcha.
We'll call them and they'll just tell us a number.
Right.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay. Great.
Because unless you pay that number, they're not gonna view you as plan completed anyways, so.
All right. I appreciate your time.
Yeah.
Discharge.
Hopefully within the next 3 weeks.
Ashley.
Yeah, because if you don't get the payment, if you don't get the money, and you still want to.